All right. So I guess we can start again with the tutorial. So let's just see if everything is in order. Let's get the presentation back up there. Yes. All right. Let's see if everybody is back. Yeah. I was just wondering, are a lot of you Discord? A lot. If you are, please share your general experience with Discord also at the end of this tutorial. We're kind of curious about it. We're just starting to use it ourselves. All right. I hope that everybody's able to hear me. Yes, it seems so. Okay, so let's get started again. So what? Not only the positioning system is very important, like we said before, but the communication with your multiple drones are also very important. But what we actually find more important is autonomy. And that's what we're going to explain you in a little bit, why we actually find it a bit more important than communication. So if you want to communicate with a swarm, so what, how we actually do that is that we do it as broadcasting. That means is that you pretty much send messages out to the entire swarm, but you don't expect a message in return from all the crazy flies. So you just send them out there. So that's called broadcasting. And that also enables us to have multiple crazy flies actually connecting per crazy radio. So that's how we're able to actually use communicate with multiple crazy flies at the same time. You all have to use the same channel, of course. That's a very important fact to have. And you cannot send to a specific trajectories at each time step. So that's a problem. You cannot do that at every time step. You cannot have one crazy fly do something crazy and the other one do it completely something else and actually say at every microsecond what one crazy fly has to do. So that means that if you're actually flying with multiple of them, the crazy flies need to do more themselves. And that in general, that holds for a lot of robots in swarm robotics as well. Because, of course, like there's a communication bandwidth. If you're using one crazy radio PA to communicate with 9 or 10 crazy flies at the same time, you'll, of course, have a communication bandwidth. So that's why it's very important to actually have more autonomy to the crazy fly itself. Before I continue any time further, we actually have to go a bit off topic because we actually have to flash all these crazy fly that are sitting here right there. That will take a little bit of a time, but it's a nice opportunity for you also to show you a nice script how you can actually flash all the crazy flies at the same time. They're all turned on, I see, so that's perfect. Let me go to VS Code. We're starting to use VS Code a bit crazy now, and we like it a lot. And we actually have, we go to examples, demos, and swarm demos. This is actually something that is in the current GitHub repository, so you can actually access that yourself. And here is the nice base station geometry that we got a minute ago. Seems to be the approximately still the same. Let's just double check. Yes, it is. And this is all the calibration values, all hard-coded, that we already got from the previous time. So this is kind of the app layer. I'm going to go through it later in this tutorial, not right now. So for now, we're just going to make it clean. Oh. So this is just making the firmware by itself. My computer is working hard, as you can see that my video is getting a bit more choppy. For tutorials, you probably would need to have a better computer. So nice lessons for us as well, trying out this new way of communicating with you guys. I just hope that my sound goes comes through correctly. All right. Just a little bit longer. This is also maybe a nice opportunity to actually show you the script that we're going to use. It's an SH bash script file. And you probably see this before. I've used this to flash the crazy flattens. It doesn't have to reboot though, so my dear assistant has to reboot all of them. while I'm not right now, but after the whole script is done, he needs to probably reboot them all to make sure that all the Lighthouse decks are on. But this is a nice script because you can just run it and then all the crazy flies will be flashed at the same time. It will take about 5 minutes though for that to work. All right, let's start the script. So it's called Cload C-Load. C-Load All. It's H. And you can find the script also in the Creation Fly firmware. Oh no. There you go. I just misspelled it. It's a dash, not an underscore. All right. So hopefully this will all be running in the meantime while I'm doing my presentation. So that's. Let's just go to the demo setup right here. Maybe a bit difficult for you to see, but currently they're all being flashed at the moment while they're on their nice little chargers. And this is going to take way too long, so we're not going to wait for that. So let's just first continue with the presentation. All right. Yeah, good question. Okay. So let's first talk about high level commander, because before this we actually said, okay, there's a communication bandwidth, you might want to put more autonomy on there. Well, the first step of that is actually using the high level commander. That's actually more of a layer between the crazy fly Python libraries you've clients and the actual functionality that sets the set points in the stabilizer loop. So that we're not going to go into specifics of the stabilizer loop. We have documentation on that on our website. If you want to know where it is, just ask in the chat right here. Yeah, so that's the kind of a more of an extra layer. And what is the principle of it? So technically, you can, for instance, you can control and crazy fly just by controlling his his attitude, which are the roll, pitch, and yaw. So that's one layer. One layer atop that is that you actually control them by saying, okay, I want you to move forward with 0.5 meters per second. That's a position velocity commander, that's how we call it. Atop of that is, I just want you to take off. So if you give a command to the crazy fly, I want you to take off to this meter, then it will actually calculate the entire way. And will actually generate onboard all the set points necessary in order to take off. But not only that, we can also, for instance, what you can see right here, that we can also, for instance, upload a trajectory up to the trajectory memory inside the crazy fly. And that we can also initiate from the CE flip by the high level commander. And then it will actually do a trajectory on the fly while it's actually. So it already has a trajectory. We flash it. We actually put it into the memory of the crazy fly, and the high level commander will activate it. So that's the general principle of the high level commander. This is actually being implemented for. It was implemented originally for Crazy Swarm. I don't know if you are familiar of that topic. It's actually in the work done by UC by James Price, Wolfgang Hunig, and more, and actually enables them to fly 49 crazy flies at the same time. This was with a mocap system, and of course they're using ROS and a more sophisticated communication scheme to communicate with the crazy flies, but still pretty impressive. So it's like 49 crazy flies flying at the same time. And the trajectories were uploaded to them when they were initiated. So that's kind of a nice example of where the high level commander is being used. So yeah, let's show you a little bit of that demo right here. Okay, so this is still running, so I have to open up a separate terminal for this. All right. This is also a script that we made ourselves. This is also something that you can also find in our CrazyFly Python library example folder, but I just copy-pasted there right here for the sake of simplicity for the tutorial. And now, actually, I will connect to a couple of CrazyFlies, maybe not 9 of them at the same time, but maybe just 2. Let's just do 2 for first. But the good question is, are they already finished with flying, with flashing? That's a good question. 1 to 5. All right, let's try that. I got the okay from Tobias. All right, let's see if we can do that. Okay, I'm going to fly now, Tobias. Let's first go to the demo, and then I will run this. Oh no! All right. Oops, I actually have to wait until they're finished because the Crazy Radio PA is actually busy with flashing. So another lesson, you cannot use CrazyFly PA for both flashing crazy flies and controlling them. So yeah, but I think there's only one more to go. But this is at least a nice demo. We're going to see a couple of them. So what I can also kind of explain what we're going to see in a minute. This is like, you know, so it actually takes like the list of URIs, and then it actually in parallel it makes up a thread per crazy fly, and then this is the most important thing. It will actually run to fly in a small box. So that's what we're going to see in a minute. So it will take off, it will fly a small box, and will land down all in high level manner. And technically, we can connect up to 9 with these. All right, they're done. So all right, let's see if we can fly them at the same time. All right, and quickly go to the demo once they're connected. Let's see. Anytime now. Seems that they're waiting for the estimated to find a position. They're finding the position. All right. Okay, so that was just 2 of them. Does any of the crazy flies need restarting, Tobias? Yeah. Okay. Always double check your crazy flies after you flush them. That's just 1. All right. So that was 2. Let's fly a few more at the same time. Maybe. Let's show where I'm Okay, so I just uncommented the top three. So we're now going to fly with 1, 5, 3, 2, 6, and 9. There's no particular reason for this order. It's just, yeah. All right. So we're going to run the script again. And nope, because I need to save my file. Classic mistake. All right. So they're all connecting. And I see that there's a problem. Number nine needs to be restarted. Yeah. Just to be clear, maybe a bit difficult for you to see that right here in the demo, but at least the lighthouse deck on top, what you should see actually at the end, it should, a couple of LEDs should start up when the Grayscale start up, and then it should be blue. If it's not only blue, there's something wrong. Also, there should be also no LED is also something wrong. All right, let's start this one again. Do we have connection? Are they all connected? Maybe we're asking a little bit too much of this. Maybe we should do a few less. I was working this morning. Famous last words. All right. Let's just only do 5. Maybe this is also the reason why we want to go to the next phase of autonomy. Yes, all right. Now, 5 will fly at the same time. Yeah, there you go. All right, perfect landing. Let's just watch that again. All right, let's see if we can go back to the presentation. Is this everything still okay, Tobias? Are they still functional? All right. Well, Tobias is fixing up these crazy fly for the next handout. So that comes also to the second or another layer of autonomy. So we have the high level commander, so you can already have at least primitives that the Crazy Fly can already have on board of them. So like taking off, flying to directory, landing, maybe also avoiding each other. That's also something that we recently got in our GitHub repository. But there's also another autonomy then you can even put on top. It's called the app layer. So that's kind of also replacing whatever we are right now doing with the CFlip, but you're actually doing on board. So the app layer is then like an onboard firmware application that you can pretty much like specify for your user or research. So it's easier to maintain because it's separate from the firmware. So you don't have to change integral parts of the firmware to actually get this to work. And you can just update the firmware alongside with it. And that also creates your ability to have more onboard autonomy without needing a PC. So it's like I said before, it is similar to the library, but it's then onboard. So, we also recently opened up the high level commander API so that the app layer is actually able to access those data and actually do the takeoff, landing, and everything like that already on board. So, all right. So this is actually an example from my own research that I've done during my PhD when I was still in TU Delft. I wasn't using the app layer then, but I made something similar. Technically, because I was flying with a swarm of crazy flies, or 6 of them, but they were flying until like almost 80 meters away from the crazy radio PA and the computer. So they actually had to fly for themselves. They were just using wall following and avoiding each other at the same time. And technically, there was already the app layer right there. So it already had an onboard state machine in the firmware. So it's usually a nice touch, I guess, also in your development, so that you can probably first try things out in the safelib Python library or the high-level commander. And then once you're happy with that, with your storm, try to convert that into an app layer to achieve more onboard autonomy on your CrazyFly. All right. Let's continue, because I think you sure want to see. Okay, so let me just quickly show you where the app layer examples are. I'm not going to show the actual making and flashing of those, because we're still fine on time, but I already flashed this CrazyFly, so I don't want to screw up the All right. Let's see. So, sorry, Tobias just told me something about... So I'm just going to show you where we actually have examples for the app layer. So you go to the folder examples in the CrazyFly firmware, and then we have a folder that is just on Hello World. It's very simple, or from peer-to-peer. App layer. We also have the one that explains all those APIs, like the high level API or the Lighthouse API that I used myself earlier, and also the demos. In demos is actually where the swarm demo is, which I'm going to explain in a little bit. All right, so let's just very quickly go to the app layer Hello World. Just the most simplest explanation of how the app layer can work. Okay, so this is the actual, this is just the code, it's very simple. You have to just make sure that you have app.h in there, for standard C libraries, and you have to define app main. So within the make file, where you make actually application folder, it's important that you actually have, the app defined at one, you define which text size you want your app to use, which programs. And this is also the CrazyFly firmware base. Where is your CrazyFly firmware base? Since this is already part of the repository, it's just a couple of folders back. So this is a very simple explanation of how the makefile actually looks for if you want to make your own app layer yourself. So we're not going to show this one right now, but at least you know where to look for. All right. Okay, so we're going to go and look at the demo implementation of the app layer. So I already showed you the Spyro before, so we now actually have the Spyro trajectory instead of uploading that from an external script first before initiating it. It's already embedded into the app layer itself. So it already has a trajectory on board. It has auto landing mechanism, so it also detects if it is not on the charging. So it will actually take off and land again on the charger. It has a pretty big state machine that does everything like that. And it also is connected with the CF client. Not the CF client, but the CF lib control tower. So that's the control tower that runs from the computer. It only indicates when a CrazyFly should start in a very broad sense. So this is the state machine that's on the CrazyFly in the app layer. And let me just go a little bit down right here. So it waits for positioning. So number 9 is not doing that at the moment, we see. And then it actually waits for standby, it's charging. And once once it gets the okay, it will take off, hover, go into the initial position of the spiral, and then run the trajectory, which is the spiral. And after 2 times or 3 times or how many times you would like to do that, it will go back to the charging pad, wait on top of the pad, try to land. But if it doesn't, it tried to reposition itself. So this is pretty much the entire state machine of our demo. And of course, it also detects when it crashed. And this is the very simple representation of our state machine of the demo. Okay, so let's go to the demo. So it's examples, demos, and swarm demo. And then you go to swarm demo. Yes, and that's app.c, and that's where the entire app is. So this is definitely a little bit more complicated than the Hello World app. But as you can see, the state machine was pretty big. This is the trajectory. I showed this before in the Python library script, but this is the entire trajectory that's now on board of the CrazyFly, which is the spiral. Yeah, so the base station calibration, K base station geometry that we showed before, which apparently works. Yeah, and I kind of invite you guys to look at the same. So maybe with the state machine I made for the presentation, you can kind of go through these cases. It's all in C. So that's the thing. It's not in Python, it's in C. But maybe it makes also a little bit more change. But that's kind of what you could do for your development cycle. First, make it in the Python CF library, and once you're happy with that, convert it to C and put it in the app layer. All right. So as I said before, we also have a control tower. So that kind of has a couple of influences there. It initiates when a CrazyFly should start, and it should take off, and it says, okay, now you should go to the initial position. And it also the dotted lines here are actually where it indicates where you should stop. So that's kind of what the control tower is doing. But it's definitely, like, in terms of communications, the way it's way less, because if you would plug out the CrazyFly PA and the CrazyFly is still in motion, it will still land. It will still reposition itself when it's trying to land. So it won't fall off there. It wouldn't do that with high level commander, but at least it will have the autonomy on there. So, all right. Okay, so the control tower, this is kind of how the old version used to look like, but it's now, it looks a little bit more different. Yeah, and it also monitors the states, the GUI right here. So the battery level, if it crashed, with the state machine, which is very handy for showing the actual workings of the demo while we're showing it to people at conferences. And like I said before, it uses very limited communication. All right. Let me just very quickly show the GUI right here. So first, you have to start the control tower. Let's make this a little bit bigger so it's a bit more visible for people to watch. Python tool tower, control tower. And right now I'm going to do 0 so that none of them will fly at the same time. And then it will start connecting. Python control tower. And this is the tower GUI. That's, oops, the active. Yes. All right. Currently, Tobias says that number 9 is not responding properly. So we're going to take, we'll get some consequence later. Now, currently, I think probably it still has the old firmware on there. So that's why it's not flashing right now. But 8 is still pretty good, I would say. We flew with 9 this morning before, so that's also able to connect. Okay, so we're able to see the states. They're all charged and ready. So you can see the battery level right here. Yeah. So maybe it would be time to just fly. Yeah, it's time to fly. Let's fly. Okay, so I just have to stop the script right here. And then I just have to remove the zero, because that means just no arguments are the standard for one. All right, let's go to the demo. So you can actually also now see the GUI right here as well. And then you see one flying. All right. Maybe we have to put the video a little bit high. Just a tiny bit. Been out of place, but yeah. Hope that everybody is able to see this from there. And it's doing the full spiral on every word. Right now it's just one flying, but let's once it lands, the other one takes over. All right. I think we get the picture. Maybe we should fly with two of them at the same time. Or not the same time, at least in the same spiral. Let's see how that goes. So if we want to fly two of them at the same time, then we can do the exact same script, and then have two instead of none or one. All right, two of them now. I'm now going to fly both simultaneously in the spiral itself, but they're taking turns. There you go. All right. Let me just go back quickly to the board here, so it's still running. So let's see if we can do the same with three. That's going to be tricky, but we have faith in that this will all work out in the end. Yeah, still only two. Maybe they're a bit afraid. Oh, there I go. Our first crash. Yeah. Okay, let's stop the three at the same time. I will just give you should So one of the good reasons why it's doing this exactly is that it's actually not flying, it's currently flying with PID. Because currently the calibration still needs to have more, needs to be a little bit better in order for the Mellinger, the controller, to actually be able to handle it properly. With the Mellinger controller, it's able to handle three at the same time perfectly. So yeah, so that's the downside of using V2 at the moment, is that because of the small imperfection, we're not able to use the more snappy controller to fly actually three at the same time. But maybe we can fly a couple of them next to each other. We can try that. Maybe we see how that goes. So then we actually go to the script again and we S. Let's see, three. Let's do three at the same time. Oh, whoops. Is it maybe 3S? Yes, it is. My mistake. It's actually saying that it cannot find a third copter that is charged and ready, so it only has two. Goes this quickly already. Okay, let's do two simultaneously. Just wait a little bit longer. All right. Two of them doing the spiral at the same time. All right. Okay, so in the meantime, I'm just going to run one so they have a little bit more time to charge. And let's go back to the presentation. So I think you guys the thing on the wall, actually, the video. It's actually the flying the crazy fly at the same time. So this is actually using the and the V1 base station that we already have in the ceiling. So actually flying 9 of them at the same time. So let's see if we're ready soon. We can also get that to work as well. Right, maybe I can lower down the charge level a little bit. Get the charge by flight is charged for flight, and we have two of them here. Yes, maybe 3.8. Let's actually indicate when they're ready. Let's see if we're able to fly maybe 3 of them at the same time. They're probably tired, just as I am. Let's see, is anything happening? Yes, 3 of them are flying. Right. We have them. Right, and now let's try 5. It's gonna be a dangerous one. Probably going to have a couple ones that are going to crash into each other, probably. Takes a bit of time, but we have 5 copters. Yes, there you go. Yes, 5 of them flying at the same time. All right. Okay. Let's just have just one of them just flying in the background. And then I think we are almost there. Well, actually, I think we're already quite there. So, just recap the steps to set up the demo. So, okay. Get the calibration data from the base station, which is handier if you actually have it already on the table. Set up the base station. Put one crazy fly on the floor with the calibration data already flashed. And then get the geometry of the base station so that crazy fly will actually indicate the point of origin of your lighthouse positioning world. And well, set up the wireless chargers, or if you don't necessarily need that, but for our demo you do. Flash all crazy flies with your app layer demo, with of course the right geometry in the calibration data, and then start the control tower script and tower GUI script, and then you're all done. So those are the recap of all the necessary steps in order to work with our Swarm demo. So what to improve in the future? So like we said before, Lighthouse 2 improvement, that is definitely something that we need to do. But we already explained the steps in the last hour. Of course, we also want them to be fully independent of the control tower. Now, it's still necessary because the crazy flies are not communicating with each other. So maybe we should implement some peer-to-peer there. And maybe some suggestions from you guys. So like, we also want to like to get manager to work with V2. So that's definitely something, but that's according to us, that's actually involves improving Lighthouse V2 in general. All right. So if there's any more questions, please ask them in the chat, and all slides and videos will be available at the event page. It's listed right here. So we'll put the slides on there and the videos of this tutorial. And while we're at it, I'm also going to look if we had any more questions asked by people in the meantime when they were signing up for this. I think actually most of them has been answered by Christopher or I. So, let me just double check. Yeah. All right, I think actually we've mostly answered all the questions, actually. If you still find some of your questions unanswered, please let us know. Please send them as an email at contact@bitcrazy.io. Or ask them here right now. So thank you guys for listening. And yeah, I'm happy that we were able to do this for you guys. I know it has been a pretty long session, so I'm happy for you if you still managed to stay until this long. Yeah, and I guess we can socialize in whatever, or ask questions here in the chat. Also, not necessarily about Lighthouse or the demo or just about anything. Yeah, that is... and also, of course, also are interested in your experience of this tutorial. We're trying different things, maybe a little bit too much. So that's... but it's always a good tryout. It's also a tryout for us to try new things, what we are also very excited about. Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, thank you guys all for attending. Okay. I'm now going to close the stream here on Discord. So you guys can just keep on chatting with each other in the chats. We'll leave it open for that. Or in Mozilla Hubs. That will also be open for a while. So for it. And yeah, thanks again. Have a great evening, morning, or night. So thanks a lot, you guys.